back to an episode of Victoria 2 Heart of Darkness, a Canadian Let's Play. Alright, so we're back here everyone, and as you can see we did a little bit of a time skip. Not that much, I was actually going to do more, but what happened was something really, really important. Look at Germany. And maybe you guys are wondering, what happened? Well, basically, right now, the First Great War is going on, and I could not laugh more when I saw the sides. It was the Ottomans, Germany, and Italy versus Austria, France, Sweden, and Montenegro. I only laughed because it was like Germany and Italy, and I was like, yeah, it's gonna be a pretty funny conquest. And so, yeah, the First Great War is going on. I'll keep you posted next time about who wins and who and what happened and who takes what. I think the Germans are probably going to win because look at this. They are taking over everything. Even with both France's and Austria's methods, they are not winning this war at all. So, yeah. We'll see though. We'll see. They could still have a chance. I mean, maybe Russia will join in at some point. I don't know. But yeah, I just want to bring you guys in for that. And next time, we'll see what happens at the end of that war. Because I'm assuming nothing else important will happen before that point. So, see you guys in a bit. Alright, so we are back everyone, and as you can see, the Great War has ended, and my thoughts on it is that it lasted about 2 years, and as far as I know, nothing changed. Like, it seems like Italy didn't get its borders changed, Germany didn't get anything out of this, it didn't even get its casus belli to flee like Norway, which I was actually looking forward to. I was like, dang, I've never seen Norway in this game, that'd be kinda cool to see. So, as for the Great War, it seems like it was a big, gigantic disappointment. In fact, most of Germany's armies are destroyed or battering. But it seems like it does not end, the woes for France does not end there, because during the war, another great power called the UK decided, hey, I want to get my cores back from Normandy, which is I still find very funny. And yeah, they seem to be in a deadlock war against that. So we'll see what happens with that. Maybe I'll come back for that, but I don't know. It seems like a small, petty thing compared to the big, gigantic Great War. So, yeah. And for me, right now, I'm just dealing with a little bit of rebel trouble. Yeah, just typical. And right now, I'm building, like, tons and tons of tanks. Like, right now, we have, I think, 29 tanks queued up. Yeah, 29 tanks queued up to try to build in all these areas. I'm hoping that this will actually work, because I'm not sure, because, you know, sometimes this game glitches out on me, but if they're not going to start building in, like, 2 years, then I'll just switch over, because then I need to seriously start building lots of tanks, because what I did was I deleted all of the, artillery from these units, and just basically, well, most of them, there's still a couple, like, engineers here and there, but most of the tanks, and most of the artillery, and now I'm going to replace them with tanks, so, yeah, that's what I'm planning to do, and, of course, the Nationalists are still in party power, and ironically, ever since I switched over to this party, there haven't been one, the capitalists have not helped me at all with building, which really does stink, so, I don't know what the deal with that is, but I don't really care, so, anyways, I'll see you guys. That was basically this little recap in, like, 1914. I'll see you guys in another little bit. Okay guys, I am back, and I got some sad news. Seems like the Chinese have civilized themselves, which means it's probably going to take much more infamy to get them, but does this mean I'm going to stop my conquest and try to still take them over? No. Even if I take the most amount of infamy, I'm still going to complete this campaign. I'm going to take over China, and that was what I achieved, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm still going to do this, and that only means that I might not be able to fit in my war with Russia, because then I'll probably be fighting like 20 different other people, so that's kind of sad to see, but I'm hoping that Gunzai will not industrialize in the next couple years, so I can go take him on, but it seems like we already had some bad luck with China industrializing, so just wanted to bring you guys in there to tell you guys what's happening, and yeah, seems like we're doing pretty good right now, so next year, I hope things will also improve a little bit better. Okay guys, I'm bringing you guys back in right before 1916, because we can now go back to war with Gunzai for the established protectorate over Gunzai. So yeah, I'm bringing you guys back in for the final war for them. I mean, this is going to be a pretty much a just slaughter still. I mean, they have not industrialized yet, so you can imagine that this is not going to be pretty for them. And we are now allowed to build airplanes, so yeah, this is gonna be pretty good. So anything that's happening new, we have tons and tons of rebellions now going on simultaneously. It's starting to become, you know, annoying. We have more and more of our troops are healing back up here. I'm gonna build my first airplanes over here because airplanes are extremely good with base defense. So they basically take the place of your French Canadian Guard because they can basically defend and attack very well, but they are not that good. I don't know. I usually have not used airplanes in the past, so I'm gonna see what they do. Hey, we're all gonna find out together what they do. So right now, as I said, I'm gaining my causes belli against the Gunzaians. Like, you see, I've not like cheated or done anything. I began at the very beginning, so we're gonna see what will happen. I'm hoping I won't take up too much. Like, I'm hoping I don't get more than 50%. 50% would be good. Would be about a good amount, because then I could probably take a little bit more. And right now we have lots of modifiers going for us, because right now we maxed out a little bit more of our technology rates. Like, we now have astronomics. What else did we get? We also got shift work, and right now I'm trying to finish up our encumbrance technology. I mean, we are nearly encumbrance, and oh, due to the excessive amounts of wealth that we have, I've had to actually turn down the taxes. So now we're only taxing all of our people by 35%, which is, I can even go down even more. Which, as I've said before, these are astronomically, in this campaign, I've never seen my levels of growth go down this much. Like, usually I have to deal with so much before my, you know, I've never usually had this less a tax rate, but for some reason in this game, I have the lessest tax rate ever. Okay, and right now we have some of the weakest armies in my entire years of ever being in China. And that's only because right now we have, I'm gonna send this army over here so that we have a good kind of army destroying these guys. The reason why we have such a horribly destroyed army is because for some reason, I don't know why, but none of our tanks are building. Like, we have our planes building, but we have none of our tanks building in any of these places. And, you know, I've tried to delete a lot of them. Like, let's just try this. We're just gonna build three tanks, because we are outproducing what we actually can build, and I'm hoping that that will help it. But it doesn't seem to be helping it at all. We don't have enough money, apparently, to do it. But that's weird, because we're making like 20... Whoa, we're making so much money a year. So much money. And we're about to go to war, and about to take over Gunzai, which is going to add, I think, another 10 or 20 million population. 13 million. Okay, so almost right in the middle, but closer to what I said earlier. So yeah, another 10 million people will add to our sphere, which then will actually make us past the 100 million mark, which is going to be the first time, people, I've ever achieved 100 million population any game. Even with the popular demand mod, I've never come that close. I mean, I've went to like 71 million, I think. And I think I just saw the infamy gain, and we gained like 19 infamy. No, 4.2 infamy. But the communists just had to attack before this happened. You know, it's a good thing they actually did attack right now, because if they attacked just a little bit later, then I probably would have had a little bit of difficulty, because I'd have to be dealing with a war and deal with them. But we just have to deal with them for quickly. If most of them are in our cap or in our main region, that's actually kind of good, because that becomes a really good thing. So let me let me see. Where's my one airplane? It's still building in Montreal. It's almost done. I can't wait till it's done. Ooh, I'm so excited. Alright, so we have all this going, more battles I'm winning. I mean, my soldiers in Canada have been at constant war. I mean, we have dealt with just blow after blow after blow after blow after blow. I mean, for some, these rebels over here, they just do not give up. They persistently try to free themselves from me. It's like, dude, I'm not gonna let you guys go anywhere. I mean, we'll just destroy you guys eventually. I don't care how much time it takes, we are going to destroy you. So yeah, it's just some annoyances like that. Let's just wait for them to destroy all these guys. Wait, is this another army that I completely forgot to deal with? I think it is. But they're traveling back to their original destination, and we're gonna soon begin the invasion of Gunzai. I think by the time these guys are all in position again, it should be already. Okay, so let's see. We're gonna need actually one more army down there because I don't quite feel like we could just sweep over them, which is kind of what we want to do. We want to make sure this war is quick and efficient. We don't want it to be long standing and drone out, because that would definitely kill us. So let's see, cause this ability to annex Gunzai. Okay, you guys ready? I'm ready for this. You guys are ready for this. Let's finally see this war. This is gonna probably be the big portion of this episode, is doing this war. Germany, very likely. Let's see if our German allies, the Germans, will join in. Okay, so let's decrease on this. Just go in. We don't even care about... Okay, let's see. You need to move right there. You need to move right there. Okay, get right there. Get right there. Okay, ah. There's a hole. So I knew there was going to be a hole somewhere in my army. So you guys, move over here. Destroy wherever you need to, and you guys just go over here and just destroy wherever army you need to. Okay, let's go back into the game. We have the Germans definitely joined my side. Didn't really think the Germans would have it in them to turn me down. Of course not, and of course with our advanced technology, definitely late in the game, this isn't really going to be much of a strategy. It's just going to be more of me just kind of going in and kicking out whatever army there is. In fact, you know what, with this army, I might just like kick out whatever Gunzaian troops try to mobilize to try to take over anything, because that actually would be a smart idea. And we have the Quindeliots Rebellion, the Quebec Rebellion, which makes absolutely no sense in all honesty. Let me see, this is counted as a support unit. Okay, that's what I thought it was. No, this is counted as horse. This is counted as a horse unit, so this is supposed to replace horsemen. But they're nowhere near as good as horsemen. I think it's just because of the defense that they're good. Anyways, my people can easily handle that. That's not too much of a difficulty. Actually, you guys will go right there, then you'll go right there, then you'll go right there, then you'll go right there. You're basically going on your warpath. Everyone, cheer on the warpath! 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 Of course not. Warpath! Warpath! Okay, we got our first conquest over here in Allendez. I'm going to cut off any other men coming into here, because we want to make sure that these guys are cut off from the main forces. Okay, of course not. Okay, yeah, these guys kind of annoy me a little bit. Okay, but I'm cutting them off so that they can't get through. Okay, we got more of our men. Alright. Seems like they might actually gain a little bit, but doesn't really matter too much. In the end, this is all just going to be mine anyway, so that doesn't really matter. I mean, I think Nanying is the capital, yeah, and I took it over, so, yeah, we're the bomb. Okay, so we have our 25 soldiers destroying them, and we have our soldiers over here just finished. We should probably divide them. You guys go that way, you guys go that way. I'm gonna try to speed this up a little bit. Just feel like just taking a little bit too much time. How unfortunate. Glory! Oh yeah, and the Olympics happened apparently. So glory to our athletes! And glory to the mighty Canadians! Who will soon destroy your soul! And at that moment, the radio broadcast cut out. No one knows what the exact message or the exact implements of the message by the Canadian presidents was felt, but I can be sure that it was meant as a practical joke and that no one should take it seriously. Those media people don't know. Alright. So anyways, we have our conquest over here going, okay. I'm not really paying attention too much. And there's a big gigantic Gunzai force. We kind of squashed them. We're just squashing the entire army. This is the final stand of the Gunzai. And Gunzai is giving a pretty good fight. Like, they're also giving a pretty good fight. I'm not going to deny. They actually, you know, are giving me, you know, a worthy fight for a last country stand. Also, kind of annoyingly, they are giving me a good fight. So, you guys go on the warpath. I think I'm going to go on a couple warpaths. Because, yeah, it seems like China has just destroyed a lot of my... Oh! Well, everyone, you know, when it comes to pass that you have such a great moment of joy that you cannot control it anymore. Yes. All right. So now we have Laura, Gunzai annexed, and our next target is the illustrious China, which, I sadly cannot annex outright anymore. I think, I think what I'm going to have to do is like go to war with it twice I think it is. Let's see, to annex it, I don't think I can annex it, but anyways, we did annex the lower part of China, and that was a pretty awesome thing to do. I mean, we have basically all of China in our midst. I mean, we have so much RGO output, and I think we're the leading producer of tea right now. Like, I think no one is beating us in tea deposits. Yep, we are the leading producer of tea by skyrocketing levels. So, anyways, people, I want to thank you guys for watching. This was a great episode for you guys. It was very much jumping around everything. I was trying to get ready for the big gigantic war. And you know what? That was the big gigantic war we needed to wait for. And with it, I think I'm actually going to retire this series. And I bet people are going to be thinking, like, what, James? But you still got a couple more wars. Well, yes, I do. But while I was, like, fast-forwarding and stuff, I started to experience slight amounts of lag. And when I was thinking about it, I was like, wait a minute. This is exactly what happened in my French campaign. And honestly, if we were to go to war against the United States and the Russian Empire, well, I'm sad to say, but this would be, it'd be way too big of a war for my computer to take, and it would probably crash it, or it'd probably be so intensive that you guys would never get to watch, and I don't think not being able to see the war is the worst part. And I mean, I remember when I played my French campaign, I remember feeling so bad that you guys did not get to see, like, all the strategies and stuff I used to, like, take over Germany and all that stuff. So, I'm planning on just, wow, I can't believe Romania is actually taking over. They've almost united all of Romania, which I am surprised about, but good job for you guys. But, so I'm planning on ending the series here. It was a good run. I mean, look at this. We've created, I mean, Chinese Canada is something I never thought I would ever see in my life. I never thought I would have 109.0 million people. I mean, the Canadian Let's Play has been definitely special. I mean, I've never played, and this is a true fact, I've never played as Canadian before today. This was really a fun Let's Play. I mean, it really was. We finished 5th in terms of power. I mean, if our population had been better and if we could assimilate cultures faster, we probably could have had this up to, like, I don't know. If we could assimilate, I wish there was a way you could, like, assimilate cultures and, like, you know, add them into secondary tiers, because if they could have, if we could have started using some of this land for production, oh my goodness, there'd be no one to stop us at this point. And, but yeah, I just want to thank you guys for watching, you know, thank you guys for supporting this Let's Play and comment, rating, subscribing, and, you know, yeah, thank you guys. So, I want to clap my hands for the final time. And everyone, say it with me for the final saying that I've been saying all this time. Glory to the Empire and God save the Queen! And with that, everyone, I'll see you guys next time.